grade will be page 32, and then you also will be taking the language quiz. Before we start that, I'm going to go over some of the charts, and we'll do the sentences on the board. We're going to do two different things to the sentences to the board. Alright, so first of all, let's talk about kinds of sentences. You will need to know enough about kinds of sentences on your quiz because you'll be writing the type of sentences they tell you. It will tell you to write maybe a declarative sentence about a chair. And maybe it'll say imperative sentence about the car. Okay, something like that. You have to read the directions. I will have read them to you already, but you need to read the directions again to remind yourself about what to do. But what is a declarative sentence? It makes a statement, a telling sentence, and ends in a
period.
An interrogative sentence?
Ask a question.
It's an asking sentence, ends with a question mark. An exclamatory sentence
shows seven or strong feelings.
It's an exciting sentence, and ends with a exclamation mark. And an imperative sentence
gives a command.
Also ends in a
period.
You need to stop playing with that. You're not wearing it because it should have just been hung up. Okay. Now let's move on to the second thing that's going to be on the quiz, and that is singular or plural. Alright, so they're going to give you a bunch of words, and you first of all need to decide if they're singular or if they're plural. If it's singular, then it means what?
One.
And if it's plural, it means?
More than one.
So it could be two. We're going to say more than one. Can we just say one for singular and more than one for plural?
Yeah.
Right? So.
Two or more.
Singular is one. No, we're going to say more than one. So we're all saying the same thing. Okay? So we're all saying the same thing. So one for singular, more than one for plural. Then you also will have to be able to tell me if it's not even a noun at all by not doing a thing to it. Remember? So the first thing you need to do is decide whether it's a noun. And if it is a noun, is it singular or plural? Okay? That's all you're going to have to do. But then they're going to give you some words, and you're going to have to fix them and make them plural. Eyes up here, please. Okay? We have a new rule from yesterday. That one will not be on the quiz. Most words, what do you do to make them plural?
Just add S.
Just add S. Most of the time, you just add S to the form, to the noun, to form the plural. Then we learned a rule. Words ending in
C-H-S-H-S-S-Z.
You add
E-S.
We're going to skip the new rule because that one's not on the quiz. Let's go to this one.
Y preceded by a consonant, change the Y to an I and add E-S.
And that's words ending in Y. I should have said that at the beginning. Words ending in Y. If there's a consonant in front of the Y, change the Y to an I and add E-S. Words ending in Y. If there's a vowel in front of the Y, you just
add S.
Our new rule from yesterday, won't be in the quiz, but we learned words ending in F or F-E.
Change the F or F-E to a B and add E-S.
That will not be on the quiz. Alright, before we get the sentences on the board, we are going to talk about nouns because we are going to find the nouns in the sentence as well as tell what kind of sentence they are. Noun is the name of a person, place, or thing. Alright, so let's look at these sentences on the board, first of all. And let's read them, and we're going to decide what kind of sentence they are and what kind of punctuation they need. Eyes up here, please. Let's read the first sentence out loud.
A skunk is a shy animal with a very powerful weapon.
What kind of sentence is that? Yes.
Declarative.
So how would it be punctuated?
With a period.
With a period. You would insert a period. And I don't really have a line up here, but let's put, for some purposes, not for the quiz, but for some tests, you have to tell what kind it is. So you put DEC for declarative. The oily spray of a skunk had, read it with me, guys.
The oily spray of the skunk has a strong, bad odor.
What would that one be, Adam?
Imperative.
So that's a command? Somebody's telling you to do something? What are they telling you to do?
Have a spray of a skunk has a strong, bad odor.
Okay.
what are you doing? What are you doing if somebody says the only spray of a cup has a strong bad odor?
Asking.
You're asking? What are you asking? What is it doing, class?
Asking a question.
Interrogative sentence, asking a question. So, Brennan, what are we going to do for the punctuation?
A question mark.
A question mark. So you would insert a question mark. All right. Read the next sentence.
If your dog is ever sprayed, you should use some tomatoes to clean off the smell.
Somebody that hasn't already answered. Carrot. Imperative. Yes, very good.
Yeah.
And so how are we going to punctuate it? Very good, with a period. Do you know where I'd need to put this period? Very good. This is one that would trick some of you up because you would put the period right here. Well, is that the end of the sentence?
No.
No. No. The end of the sentence is right here. That's where you need to put the period. Alright, last minute, everybody.
An animal that has been sprayed will never leave skunks alone.
Jonathan?
Exclamatory?
Yeah, we could do that one explanatory. You might could say that one as a declarative, but they were wanting you to think of exclamatory, so that's good. Alright, and so I just put the punctuation without making you guys tell me. I don't know why I did that.
Exclamatory.
Exclamation mark. Very good. All right. So that is not on the test. Now we're going to go back and do these sentences again, but this time we're just going to tell what the nouns are. So everyone stand up. You get to sit down and you tell me a noun. All right. A skunk is a shy animal with a very powerful weapon. Eric.
Skunk.
Skunk is a noun. Give me another noun. Brennan.
Weapon.
Weapon. Very good. All right, Grace.
Animal.
Very good. And that's all in that sentence. I hope you weren't thinking of anything else. That's all in that sentence. Let's go to the next sentence. The oily spray of a skunk has a strong bad odor. Olivia.
Skunk.
Skunk. That's the easy one. Now there are two more. Bam.
Oily.
No.
Spray.
Spray. Oily describes spray. What kind of spray is oily spray? Okay, so it's not watery, it's oily. The stuff that comes out of a skunk is an oily spray. So oily will be an adjective. We don't learn those yet. Oil is a noun. But oily is an adjective. Okay? Right, do you see another one though? Micah?
Odor.
Odor. Odor is a noun. Very good. Have you ever smelled a skunk? Jonathan.
Skunk.
Skunk. Very good. That is the only one in that sentence. If your dog is ever sprayed, use juice from tomatoes to clean off the smell.
Tomatoes.
Tomatoes. Very good. Give me another one, Zeke.
Dog.
Dog. Abby. Sprayed is something you do. Like the skunk did it. Skunk sprayed. Spray was the oily spray. So like back to a bottle and went spray would come out, right? That's the noun of it. But there's also the action of it. So in this case, they're talking and saying if your dog is ever sprayed, that's gotta be the verb. Okay? The action. Owen?
Juice.
Juice. In this case, we're talking about juice from tomatoes, but there's orange juice, apple juice. There's lots of different kinds of juice, aren't there? One more. This one's a little You guys could smell the rose, right? It had a smell, right?
No.
Okay. It doesn't matter whether you did or not. Some of us did. Okay? So you don't have to go no. If you had gotten closer to it, you wouldn't have smelled it. Last sentence, everyone. An animal that has been sprayed will remember to leave skunks alone. Abby?
Skunk.
Yes. And everybody, so everybody can sit down. What's the only word? Noun in the sentence.
Animal.
Alright, now all of you may sit down. I didn't have enough for everybody. I was thinking I would, but I did not do that. Some of you guys never got a chance. Alright, let's look at your paper today. Alright, so we are going to do a lot of nouns today on your paper. You see a picture, you're going to use the picture, and we are going to talk about it together. And I'm going to be erasing those sentences so I can write some of those on board. Looking at the picture, they want you to find four plural nouns. So there has to be more than one of that thing in the picture. So raise your hand, no blurting out. So this is the first section on your paper. All right. Micah.
Logs.
There are logs in this picture. And you should write logs. Put your hands down until you've written logs. Okay? Adam, what else?
Trees.
Trees. There are trees in this picture. Grace.
Marshmallows.
Is there more than one? Yes, there is. Very good. Marshmallows. And you might want to look at that to see how that is spelled. But you do need to write the plural of it. Because if you don't write the plural, you're writing the singular of it. Jonathan, put your chair down, please.
Flames.
Say it again.
Flames.
I don't think anyone has ever thought of that one. It's not even one of the book lists, but that is true. I know, but we're going to. You don't have to be flames. We're going to do as many as we can. You get to choose what you write. What else?
Fireflies.
Do you see fireflies?
Yeah, fireflies.
1, 2, 3.
All right, let me open one of your books because I can't see them in my book. My picture's too tiny. Okay, good job. That's another one. Fireflies is a possibility. You do not have to write every one of these. You just need to write four. But we're going to come up with as many as we possibly can.
Stars.
All right, and there is one more that you could say, even though they're not the same, if you put them in a certain category, they are the same, so they're plural. Adam?
Nocturnal creatures.
Oh, my word, that's great. They didn't list it that way. They call them something more simple. But animals. Yes, they are nocturnal creatures. But we would just say creatures.
Why are the other ones?
Creatures, what would you say? No, you're blurting out so you don't get to say it.
Well, there's rocks for the fire pit.
Yes, there are rocks for the fire pit. But instead of calling them creatures, what could you have called them?
Animals.
That was what I was going for.
Or critters.
Well, critters is sort of slimy. So, I prefer animals or creatures. I really don't want you to put critters. Grass?
Grass.
Say it again.
Grass.
That one's iffy because we're not sure. They're not real showing grass definitively, are they?
Well, there's lines.
Yeah, we're going to stop there anyway.
What?
We have enough. I mean, my gracious, we only need four. And look how many we put.
I'm going to take a car.
Okay, there's a problem with saying that. What's the problem with saying that? What are you supposed to be doing? What were the instructions?
Plural.
Yes, the instructions were plural. All right, let's go to the next thing. And it says find two singular. So, Owen, can you give me the singular?
Guitar,
yes. And by the way, you better look at how guitar is spelled because probably not too many of you know how to spell guitar. Actually, I'm going to switch to a different color so that you guys can see that I'm doing a different thing. Let's put guitar over here. Guitar. This is how you spell guitar. Alright? And then we need another one that is singular. And I need
need to find your paper. Here. Plural means more than one. You need to write one of these words. Actually, four. Take four. Four different words. Just four. Okay? We have lots to choose from. And then in the second section where they're asking you to write the singular, you'll do this one. And then what else can we put?
Sky. Because we can, because there's only one sky.
That is true, but is there ever more than one sky?
No.
No. I'm not going to say that one. That one just gets... Yes, Adam.
There's one branch. Like on the branch on the side.
Okay, now, that tree would have more than one branch. And actually, you can see more than, you can see lots of trees with lots of branches in the background. Yes?
This is for plural, but stripes.
Okay, we're not going to go back to plural, okay? Can we just stick to what we need to do? Mm-hmm. Guys, please, somebody tell me something singular. Maya.
I was going to say one of the animals, owl.
Yes, thank you. That's what I need you guys to do. And you can do a different animal. What other animal do you see, Abby?
Raccoon.
Is it a raccoon?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, and there's one more animal. And you guys only have to do two of these, Ben.
A possum.
A possum. And please look at how opossum is spelled. And raccoon, by the way. All right. Yes? You have another one?
Charcoal under the pile.
Say it again?
There's charcoal.
Okay, charcoal would be one line. All right? Because you apply it one line. How do you know it's charcoal, though? They don't definitively show you what's in the fire. Do they? Okay. Well, it's going to be more than one anyway. It's not singular. We're doing singular. All right, now you're going to write an interrogative sentence about the picture. So what are you going to do? Interrogative sentence. What is that?
I have a question.
Thank you. You're going to ask a question. That's all you need to tell me. You guys who are shrugging at me, it just means you're going to ask a question about the picture. Then you're going to write an exclamatory sentence about the picture. So now you're going to write what kind of sentence?
Something exciting.
Something exciting. And then you're going to write two declarative sentences about the picture. And last of all, you're going to write two details about the picture. So these are not sentences. These are just little phrases, something you see in the picture. All right? Yes?
I know an interrogative sentence.
Okay, but I don't want you guys to tell me the interrogative sentence. You need to just do them. Okay? Because otherwise, somebody else will copy your interrogative sentence. I know that for a fact because it's happened in the past. All right, you may finish up that paper and then we'll be taking the